Yo, my blood's boiling thinking of that guy, you know. Like, I want to kill him. I am extremely fucking angry and I've had the worst day ever, guys. Literally, I feel that passionate about this problem right now, yeah. I thought I'd just switch on the camera and express it this way. Because Chloe, yeah, doesn't want to hear me moaning to her because, like, I've been pissed off most of the morning. Basically, I needed a haircut, okay. Bear in mind, yeah, my hair has been through some absolute states, okay. I've took a bath in henna, my hair's been bright orange. I've had my hair fucked up by Ramel, shaved it off. He's put hair removal cream in my hair. My hair has been bleached blonde, okay. But nothing in the past compares to how I feel about my fucking haircut right now. I'll take the cap off, just listen to what I gotta say first. My actual hairdresser is based in Birmingham. I go there every single time and I've been going there for about a year now. I have never had a haircut from someone as good as these guys. Like, they are so sick. Thing is, you pay a little more, but you get a great experience when you're in there. I pay a bit more because of the quality of the haircut, basically. The haircut quality they give me is, like, it's unbeatable. But today, I couldn't go there because it was a bit out of the way. It was a bit far, and yeah, I just didn't have time. Probably the biggest mistake I've ever made. Okay, I just want to stress to you, okay? To me, a haircut is so fucking important, yeah? And if someone has that job in their hands, right, and they make a mistake cutting your hair, it can ruin your entire week, because that's what it's done for me. I'll probably wake up tomorrow, I feel a lot better, but today I feel like trash. There comes a price with going to somebody for convenience. Cheaper price, closer, overall just easy to access. Do you know what I'm saying? My girlfriend Chloe referenced this hairdresser in the nearby town, which is where she's from, so I took her word for it. She said he's amazing. I said, is he good? She said, yeah, he's really good. I didn't ask why he's really good. I'll get to that in a second. She's laughing at me. She's laughing. She's sat on the bed next to me laughing. She knows, yeah, that a ceiling fan has a better haircut than this. I look like trash under this hat. So I walked into the hairdresser and I was like, hey dude, man, you okay? The guy's sitting there, yeah, on a settee, eating chicken off the bone. Enjoying his break. No one's here. I'm the only one who's just walked in. Enjoy your chicken. Told him to enjoy his food. Not to worry, not to rush. He got up, right, scoffed his chicken wings and went into the kitchen, rinsed his plate and come back out. How you doing, mate? Sit down. I was like, yeah, man. How much is it for, like, a haircut? Shape up my stubble here. He said £10. Guys, if you want a high quality haircut, right, if you want to change your life and you take pride in how you look, if you're a white person with texture to your hair, you have to have layers, you have to have blending with scissor cut, yeah? Don't go to somebody that charges £10. I'm sorry, £10, yeah? If you divide that by the time that it takes them to do your hair, in this case, it took him fucking 4 minutes. Yo, what's the math? Let me work out the math. Yo, never mind the maths. Fuck the maths. I can't think right now. It cost me £10 to have my hair cut. I should have walked out at this point. But no, I took my girlfriend's word for it. The guy asked me what I wanted. Told him exactly what I wanted. I want a grade 1 going into a grade 2. Leave the top long. Do not touch the top and let it hang over. So it's like an undercut. So the top kind of hangs over the side. So I can have my hair slicked back. So I can have my hair finally how I used to have it, slicked back, and the sides going with it. He said, yeah, that's fine, mate. Tell me why he pulls out a grade 1 and just does this. Zzz, zzz, zzz. But he doesn't take his time. He does this with his wrist action. He's just there digging at my head, yeah, like he works at a church. Does my head top look like a grave? No, it doesn't. I was patient with him. I was like, okay, maybe he's gonna, you know, do some bits with my hair. I was fucking wrong. 4 minutes after doing this, yeah? He says, yeah, you're done, mate. What do you mean? What do you mean you're done? What? No, no. It doesn't take 4 minutes, yeah, to cut somebody's hair. I'm sorry, yeah. Spend time on making someone look good, okay? If you're a barber, do your job properly. You can't rush somebody's hair. Lesson learned from this. Please take my advice. If you go to a barber, right, traditionally, if you go there every week, every month or whatever, you go to your barber strictly. Do not go to somebody else out of convenience, even if it's because you don't have enough money or your hair's really long and you got a special event coming up you need to look good for. Trust me, it is not worth going to somebody else. Wait it out. Oh, this goes for girls as well. Don't go to any hairdresser who you don't trust. Guys, just go with what you know and just stick to your barber. I said leave the sides hanging over. What's this? The guy clipped my hair to one side and did this with a grade 1. Look at the back of my head. What is that? I look like a fucking pelican. I can't even do nothing with that. I can't even slick it back.
You know why? Because there's little hairs here that just flick out. And do you know what's even worse? The guy's barber equipment wasn't even good at all. Because he shaved my head, yeah? All the hairs are really sharp on the back of my neck. And every time I do this, it scratches my neck. Yo, yo. I'm not even going to call the guy out because I don't want to ruin his business. Because there's people out there who might enjoy his hairdressing or his barber work that he does for them. But for me, yo, you'll never fucking see me again.
Couple times I was cautious. Couple times with no warning. Couple times Stone Cold Stunner. Couple times Stephen Hawking. I don't wanna hear their mama. You can miss me with the bullshit. Swear life just gets dumber and dumber as the drugs get moreish. Couple times I lost my friends. Couple times I got new ones. But who gives a fuck about them? Man, I gotta do it on my